Hi everybody! In this video, I'll be showing you how to use VCCV English in Classic UTAU using the LyricParser plugin, and I'll put a link for this plugin in the video description. This is not an UTAU tutorial, so if you're unfamiliar with the UTAU interface, your sampler engines, different file types, recording methods, etc., I encourage you to have some general understanding before we get started. I'll link some resources in the video description, if you're new. And with that, let's just jump right in. So step one is to import your VSQ or MIDI or what have you, and begin formatting the syllable break style for LyricParser. LyricParser breaks syllables almost exactly like Vocaloid does, where we indicate the break with a hyphen. So you want the first syllable followed by a dash. See, we break the word number here, and victory here, royale, tomato, so on and so forth. You can change where the syllable breaks occur by changing the placement of the hyphens, and here's an example here. So when it's formatted correctly, go ahead and select all the notes using Ctrl W and run the plugin. Firstly, go into settings and uncheck this first box here. You can try using it, but I find that it can mess up the timing on the UST. And hit save. Okay, and save. Now, select English from the drop-down here, VCCV, and before we go any further, look up here in this Errors tab. Here you will be shown sections that are either not formatted correctly or words that are not in the dictionary. So here we can see tomato, pleasant, and Xbox are not in the dictionary yet, so we're gonna have to add them. So this column here, this length column, indicates how many syllables are in the word. And here is where we're gonna enter the phonemes. The format for creating dictionary entries goes like so. For each syllable of the word, you put the consonant and the vowel in parentheses. And then a colon indicates the next syllable, the syllable break, ta, and then may, and then do. I've included a VCCV phonetic chart below to show you all the available vowels and consonants in a VCCV voice bank, so you can refer to that for help as you're working. So I'll go ahead and do the rest. Ple, zint, X, box. And if you want more examples on how to enter words, you can open the dictionary file inside of LyricParser, and you can see tons of examples on how to enter words this way. So once you've entered your words, go ahead and hit update dictionary and parse, and let's go back over to this tab here. So here, these are all the words in the UST. Here are the phonemes, and you can actually go in and edit these before we parse the UST, but I'm just gonna leave it as it is for now. So now we're ready to parse, but this part is a bit hit and miss. It is a bit buggy. Sometimes half the UST will disappear or will be off time after hitting confirm. If there's an issue, try putting at least two rests at the beginning and the end of the song. Then select all the notes with Control W. This selects only the notes, so it excludes the beginning and ending rests. Try running the plugin again, and hopefully it's fixed. If this doesn't fix it, just parse the UST in small sections at a time, and it should be fine. So I'm gonna go ahead and hit parse, and then confirm. Once it's parsed, make sure to go in and clear the envelopes. I like to set this to 100, just as a starting point. And reset the envelopes. And now you can try listening to it, but we have a bit of work to do yet.
We got a number one victory royale, yeah, Fortnite, we about to get down.
The timings are clunky, and some parts are incorrect, like this part here on Just Wiped. Overall, the logic is mostly right, but we can still improve it. From here, you can also open the UST and OpenUTAU, if you prefer to edit in there. So step two is editing the parsing logic and phonemes. This next step may be a bit confusing to newcomers, so if you're intimidated, UST is probably in a good enough state to continue to step three. But I do encourage you to have a decent understanding of VCCV functionality, and I've included a guide below detailing the phonetic structure of VCCV and how to use it. But anyway, let's take a look at what we have here now. Right off the bat, I notice a few spots where we could improve the parsing logic. We can have an M to B transition here. We can have an N to V transition here. So I'm just gonna make this a syllable ending VC into a parsing VC. And again here, we can have an L to Y transition. Here, there's no need for it to be this way, so I'm just gonna make this an L to Z transition, and make this a Z, instead of just a standalone vowel. Here, this sound does not exist, so I'm just gonna edit this. Let's try it like this. So far, so good. Here we can have an M to N transition. Here we can have an N to DH transition. One way you can check that a sound even exists in the voice bank is to highlight it and press Control G. So this sound does exist, I wasn't sure. If it exists, a window like this will pop up. If it doesn't, you'll just get this. This only works in Classic UTAU though. So I've gone in, I've edited the parsing logic a bit, I've added some more transitions, and it's better. Now I'm gonna go in and edit some of these phonemes to get a more natural sound. For example here, I might not fully voice the T here, Fortnite. So I might make this a syllable connecting piece. You can see there's a pause here. And not as opposed to this one, which is a fully voiced hurt. It might sound more natural to have a pause here, an unvoiced T. Same thing for here. Here we have a voiced T out, but it might sound more natural to have an unvoiced T here out. Here's another instance where it might sound more natural to have an unvoiced sound here. And again here. And again, another instance here. And again here. Here again, might sound more natural. And here. You can try saying the words out loud to hear how you might pronounce it more naturally as you go. Here again, take me, as opposed to take me, might sound more natural. And again here. Here again. I think these would all sound better unvoiced. And here again.
We got a number one victory royale, yeah, Fortnite, we about to get down.
Okay, so I like what I see here. I've edited the parsing logic, and I've changed some of the phonemes. And now I'm gonna move on to step three, which is making finer adjustments. So now I'm gonna start doing fine-tuning to the timing, the volume, the consonant velocity. So you can adjust the size of these boxes by holding control and dragging. And another thing you can do is go into the property using control plus E, and you can increase consonant velocity, which helps if there's a lot of clutter going on, if there's too many consonants happening all at once. And lastly, you can adjust the volume by clicking here and just dragging up and down on the envelope itself. So I'm gonna use all those principles and just fine-tune throughout. And it really just comes down to listening to it over and over and making little changes. I'll just speed through this process in the video.
We got a number one victory royale, yeah, Fortnite, we about to get down. 10 kills in the board right now, just walked out Tomato Town. My friend just got downed, I revived him, we're heading southbound. Now we in the Pleasant Park streets, look at the map, go to the mock cheat. Take me to your Xbox to play Fortnite today. We can go to Misty Mire, but not Loot Lake. I'd really love to chug with you. We can be pro Fortnite gamers.
So this is what I have now. It sounds much better. And of course I could go in and make even more adjustments. But for the purpose of this video, I think this is fine. And that about covers everything. You can check the guides included with the plugin itself if you need more information. But anyway, I hope you found this video helpful. Give the video a like, and leave a comment if you have any questions.